हेलो, आई एम गणेश बियागलावे, वर्किंग एज एन असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर इन डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ मैकेनिकल इंजीनियरिंग, वालचंद इंस्टीट्यूट ऑफ टेक्नोलॉजी, सोलापुर. इन दिस सेशन वील सी वेपर कॉम्प्रेशन साइकिल, द बेसिक्स रिक्वायर्ड. लर्निंग आउटकम: एट द एंड ऑफ दिस सेशन स्टूडेंट्स विल बी एबल टू डिस्क्राइब सिंपल कार्नोट साइकिल. सेकेंड, डिस्क्राइब रिवर्स कार्नोट साइकिल एंड एक्सप्रेस टन ऑफ रेफ्रिजरेशन. कंटेंट्स: फर्स्ट वी विल सी सिंपल कार्नोट साइकिल, देन रिवर्स कार्नोट साइकिल एंड डेफिनेशन एंड एक्सप्रेशन फॉर टन ऑफ रेफ्रिजरेशन विच इज रिक्वायर्ड फॉर टू स्टडी रेफ्रिजरेशन एंड एयर कंडीशनिंग. इन द फर्स्ट पार्ट, that is simple Carnot cycle, in the simple Carnot cycle there are four processes. I will show these are four processes on TS diagram. So process 1 to 2, 2 to 3, 3 to 4 and 4 to 1. Already you have studied this Carnot cycle in basic mechanical engineering in first year. So can you think over the two types of the process which are involved in the Carnot cycle? Try to recall. Yes, there are two isothermal processes and two isentropic processes. In the Carnot cycle, we assume the hot body is brought in contact with the piston and cylinder arrangement. Then the heat will be supplied to the piston cylinder. Because of this heat supplied, we may get work. The work done by the engine or the cycle, Carnot cycle, will be during process 2 to 3, which is isentropic process. Entropy is constant. During process 1 to 4, the heat will be rejected. Now, for to reject this heat from the piston cylinder, the cold body is required to be brought in contact with the cylinder head. So this will be heat rejected. Then process 4 to 3 is once again the isentropic process. Isentropic process, entropy is constant and work required to be done on the system. So the cycle 1, 4, 3, 2, 1 is simple Carnot cycle. We have derived the efficiency for the simple Carnot cycle as output to the input, that is heat supplied. The output can be written as heat supplied minus heat rejected divided by heat supplied. Now, though the numbers are not in flow with the clockwise direction of the cycle, as this is simple Carnot cycle, we'll see after this simple reverse Carnot cycle. For that cycle I have written 1, 2, 3, 4 notations. You can change the notations. Instead of 3, you can write here 1, 2, 3, 4 also. Now, the efficiency of the Carnot engine will be equal to, now for this I will take this as the high temperature source, because T3 is equal to T2 and this as low temperature sink as T4 is equal to T1. Both these processes are isothermal processes. Now, this can be represented by high temperature minus low temperature divided by high temperature. So, this is the simple Carnot cycle. In the reverse Carnot cycle, now we will see the reverse Carnot cycle. what I will do? I will just change the direction of the processes. Once again, I will show the rectangle, that is processes, four processes on the TS plane. 1, 2, 3, 4. Now simply I will change the rotation or direction. So 1 to 2, 2 to 3, 3 to 4, and 4 to 1. This becomes a reverse Carnot cycle. In this cycle, 1 to 2 is not the work developed process. The work is required to drive the compressor. So the work will be consumed by the compressor during process 1 to 2. Obviously, it is isentropic compression process. Process 2 to 3 is the heat rejection process. Now, here we will consider condenser, because in the refrigeration, condenser is used to reject the heat. During process 3 to 4, there may be work development depending upon the type of the cycle. Here, the work will get developed. And process 4 to 1 is the heat absorption process. Here we are calling it as a refrigerating effect. Now, in the reverse Carnot cycle, we can't use the eta term for efficiency. So, effectiveness is calculated using the term coefficient of performance. And for refrigerator, suffix is written as R. Now, so it is the COP. COP is the ratio of desired effect, nothing but refrigerating effect here, to the work done to achieve this effect. Now, how much work is required? That is WC. So, this can be written as refrigerating effect divided by QC minus QR. Now, this Q can be replaced by temperature. Once again, I will use the notation TH and TL. Now, the heat is absorbed from the source at low temperature. So, here I can write TL divided by TC is high temperature sink. So, this is TH minus TL. So, this will be the Carnot COP for refrigerator. Similarly, I can write Carnot COP for heat pump. As now, in the heat pump, the desired effect will be the heat addition into the room. So, QC divided by same work will be required by the heat pump. So, it will be the ratio of TH divided by TH minus TL. Remember, the Carnot COP of heat pump is always greater than Carnot COP of the refrigerator. Next is the third point, definition of ton of refrigeration. So, ton of refrigeration is defined by the ASHRAE as 1 US ton water is taken, which is taken at 0 degree Celsius, required to be converted into ice at a same 0 degree Celsius. So, the ton of refrigeration is defined as the amount of heat removed from 1 US ton water at 0 degree Celsius to be converted into ice at same temperature in 1 day or 24 hours. So, 1 ton of refrigeration will be equal to, now here 1 US ton ice is nothing but 907 kg of water. Now this water is to be converted into ice, means latent heat is to be removed from that water, which is 335 kilojoule per kilogram. In 1 day or 24 hours are to be converted, 24 hours are to be converted into seconds. If we'll do the calculation, then we'll get the exact figure as 3.5167. Here kilogram, kilogram will get cancelled, the unit will be kilojoule per second, nothing but 3.5. For all calculations in refrigeration and air conditioning, we use, we'll take 3.5 kilowatt. Now, this you can convert into kilojoule per minute or BTU per pound, etc., etc. But for all numerical calculations, we'll be considering 1 ton of refrigeration as 3.5. For further study, you can refer Refrigeration and Air Conditioning by C.P. Arora and Refrigeration and Air Conditioning by W.F. Stoker. Thank you.